Oh yeah, yum. You know it. So I'll put these in there.
They're arranged in a pattern like that. So it's hyphy. Like that.
So this gets nice and hot again. I mean, it was sitting there on medium. It was smoking hot, so then I had to redo the oil in it. But, take all three of your packets here.
And then, you're gonna save these because they're gonna get added in there. I thought, you know, I don't have any meat that was already left overcooked or busted any of the cans of meat, so I'm gonna use this leftover cheesy rice. And it should work out good. I'll put the water in this container after I brown this stuff here. You'll want to add oil. Just a decent amount. I mean, you can see I used probably 2 ounces, maybe 1.5 ounces. And you just put them on there. Let them brown up. Can flip them over. See, sizzle, sizzle, that's the trick. Just get a little color to it, you don't want to burn it. That's the trick with this ramen, become a 5,000 ramen master. Cooking this shit for 25 years. 35 years, shit. Now the broken up ones will cook a little bit faster, you can see in there, right there on the edges. And so that'll be high time for you to add your water. Well, that's a good one there. See, we want it like that. I got about 12 to 16 ounces. Once you throw it in there, that's when things will start happening quick. Now the whole idea is all of that's going to evaporate and go into this. So it's not going to be like a soup, like your regular white trash ramen style soup. This is the bonus, how to open a ramen packet. And then you shake it down to the bottom, so then you're not gonna lose any when you rip this off, because it's pressed. There's seasoning all up in the top. Man. Sometimes the ramen be fighting with you. The ramen be pissed at you. Ramen fucking cussing you out and shit. Angry ramen. I'm gonna add some hot sauce to mine. It's gonna be some furious anger from this ramen. Damn. Whoa. This can be rolling like this at any time. This already cooked, so you know, I'll be adding it at the end. Again, this leftovers from something. They'll kind of have a weird, kind of like a, just a different version of a rice-a-roni or what have you, something like that. So, just got the honey going. Oh, yeah. So, you want a few spoonfuls. I'm having trouble getting out like that. Sorry, man. Sometimes you just can't help yourself. Know what I mean?
got a little bit in there before. Ooh, ooh, and then go wait. It's mixing up so good. See this? Most of that moisture is already gone in there. Alright, you hear that awesome sound? That means we're done. Ain't no liquid left. It's all ready to go. I like to do mine with some of this, but, you know, ain't gonna be for the kids like that. Ain't no spoon. That's a spoon. Let's just have a little sampler. My dog bowl. The glory. That's awesome. It's so good. Got the chicken flavor and the cheese coming through in a major way. Like and subscribe. Cookout Northwest. Matt Bistro TV.